We all want to give our children what they need to grow to their full potential. And as parents, we play an important role in their development. But our parenting is affected by the supports and challenges in our lives, including experiences that cause what's known as toxic stress. Stress is called toxic when it doesn't let up. And there aren't supportive relationships to help us cope. That can make it hard to get through the day, let alone be the best caregivers we can be. The overwhelming burden of toxic stress can affect the health and well-being of adults. It can also affect the development of children in ways that can last a lifetime. Stress that puts us in a constant state of fight or flight can make it feel like we're always on edge, or like it's impossible to calm down. And these feelings can overload our ability to provide the supportive relationships that children need in order to thrive. Think of toxic stress as heavy cargo. Just as a truck can only haul so much weight before it stops moving forward, challenging life circumstances, like losing a job or not having a place to live, can weigh us down. And just as a truck can break down if it carries too much for too long, we too can wear down from being overburdened without the support we need. When toxic stress is related to things we can't control, like poverty, abuse, or racism, it can feel especially heavy to take on. But experiencing toxic stress doesn't have to determine who we are or how we act. And understanding how stress affects us can empower us to make change in our lives. There are things we can do to buffer ourselves and our children against the effects of even the most intense stress. Just as redistributing cargo from an overloaded truck can help it run again, supports and services, things like food pantries, job training programs, or even just talking with someone who cares, can help us focus on caring for ourselves and our children. And just as regular maintenance is required to keep a truck running, reliable access to community services can help us manage the load during challenging times. Reaching out to get support can be difficult. But things that might seem very small, like sitting and breathing deeply, playing I Spy with your child, or even sharing a walk or a snuggle, can make a difference. Over time, these small steps can build our resilience and our children's by strengthening the skills and relationships that help us cope. And our communities can build resilience too by providing services and opportunities that help all families thrive. Supports like these help build a strong foundation for developing brain architecture. So the earlier we can provide them, the better. But the brain is capable of change throughout life, and it's never too late for a tune-up. Coping with and healing from toxic stress takes a lot of effort and support. But we all need the help of others in difficult times. And building resilience and strength in our families and communities is one of the most important investments we can make as a society. In the end, it will help all of us become the parents that we want to be.